Hello children, how are you all? I hope you all must be in the pink of your health. Myself Nisha Soni is back with a new video in maths, that is for the topic geometry. Okay, so let us begin. Children, today in this topic we will learn about point, line, line segment, ray. Okay, so let us proceed. What is a point? A point is a dot. Or we can say that a dot represents a point. A simple dot represents a point. We represent points with capital letters A, B, C, D or any other letter which you want. Now children, a point shows an exact location. Okay, a point shows a particular location. And you know, it has no length, no breadth or no depth. Okay, that means in short you cannot measure a point. Now see children, for your convenience I have drawn four points over here: point A, point B, point C, point D. See children, if you will name the point, then only you can easily identify the location. Okay, that this is point A, this is point B. Okay, now see what's next. Line segment. Now children, see here there are two points A and point B. So we can go from point A to point B in many ways. So I have drawn three ways over here. One is this one and one is your this one. Now tell me which is the shortest distance between point A and point B. Yes, you are correct. The straight path is the shortest distance between point A and point B. So this shortest path between two points is called a line segment. Okay, and a line segment has how many endpoints? It has two endpoints. Now here you can see that AB is a line segment and it has two endpoints, that is point A and point B. Now children, whenever two line segments meet, they meet at a point. See, here two line segments are meeting, and where they are meeting? They are meeting at point C. Now in figure number 2, the lines are meeting at point B. Figure number 3, where the two lines AB and CD are meeting? They are meeting at point P. Okay, so if the two line segments meet, where they will meet? They will meet at a particular point. Now children, what is a line? A line is different from a line segment. So don't confuse between a line and a line segment. A line goes on and on forever in both directions. Okay, now the picture of a line is drawn by putting arrowheads at both the end. You can see the arrowhead over here and the arrowhead over here. So this tells us that the line is moving in both the direction. Okay, and I have drawn two particular points over here, A and B. So this AB is the line segment. Okay, so a line segment is a part of a line. Okay, now what is a line? A line is different from a line segment and it goes on and on forever in both the direction. The arrowhead tells us the direction of the line. Okay, now children, with the help of the line segments we can draw figures. Okay, with the help of the line segments I have drawn few figures over here. You can see this is your triangle, then this is your four-sided figure. Okay, this is your six-sided figure. Okay children, now you can draw as many as figures as you want. Okay, by meeting the line segments, by joining the line segments. Okay, now children, what is a ray? A ray is a straight arrow that has no fixed length but goes on and on away from its initial point. So see, initial point, what is the initial point? Initial point means the starting point. Okay, now our ray AB is moving in which direction? It is moving in the direction of B. Now, children, we all know that sun rays are falling over here and there, and they are straight rays, isn't it? So where do they start from? They start from the sun and fall everywhere, isn't it, in a particular direction? That is why they are called ray. Do they have any fixed length? No, they don't have any fixed length. That is why they are called ray. Now, children, a ray has one starting point, which is called its initial point. Okay, which is called its initial point. This point is called vertex. What it is called? Vertex. To name a ray, first name its initial point. Okay, if I want to name this ray, then what will be its name? Its name will be AB. Okay, and I have shown the direction where the line is going, where the ray is going. It is going in the direction of B. Okay, now I want to write the name of the second ray. So what I will write, from where it is starting, where is the initial point? B. So what I will write? B A, like this, arrowhead. Where the arrowhead is going? In the direction of A. So the name of the ray is BA. Okay, children. Now, children, tell me one thing. Is ray AB equal to ray BA? Are both the rays same? No, both the rays are not same. Why? Because you can see that their initial point are different. That is why they are not same. Okay, children? Now, how to measure a line segment? To measure a line segment, we will place the line with the near the or with near the zero of the ruler. Okay, when we will keep the line near the zero of the ruler, the first end point will be near the zero, and where the second end point will be, we will get the reading on the ruler. That will be the measurement of the line. Okay, children, now let us measure it. Okay, so what is the length? The length of the line segment AB is 8 centimeter. Okay, children. Now, if you want to draw a line segment of a particular length, suppose you want to draw a line segment AB of length 7 centimeter. So what you will do? Same way, you will start from the zero. Okay. And here we have drawn a line of 7 centimeter. Children, one thing you have to remember is that to draw, whenever you want to draw a line of a particular length, you have to start from zero of the scale. Okay, understood? Now, children, let us recall what we have learnt. So we have learnt that a point shows a definite location. Okay, and it is represented by a capital letter. Okay, a line segment has two endpoints. How many endpoints? Two endpoints. Okay, then the initial point of a ray is called its vertex. And what is the plural of vertex? It is vertices. So the initial or the original point of a ray is called its vertex. Now, children, ray AB is not same as ray BA. Why? Because both of them have different initial point and both of them are going in different direction. That is why ray AB is not same as ray BA. Now, children, if you want to measure a line segment, then what you have to do? Keep the zero mark of the scale at one end point, and the mark at the other end point will give you the reading of the length of the line segment. Okay, children. Now, I have some work for you. And what is that? Draw some line segments in your notebook and try to measure them. Thank you. Have a good day.